VirtualBox is a free virtual machine. It is a free download at virtualbox.org. It works on Windows, Mac OS X, Linux, and Solaris. The free VirtualBox images can be downloaded at osboxes.org, virtualboximages.com, and virtualboxes.org. There are different versions of Linux, FreeBSD, FreeDOS, and other operating systems found at those three sites. 7-Zip is needed to unzip the images. It is a free download at 7-zip.org. This is 100% legal, as those sites are just distributing free and open source operating systems. The username, password, and installation notes are found at the individual disk image download link. This is a general list of the operating systems available for download between the three sites. A few images have been downloaded. They are in 7-zip format. VirtualBox has already been installed on this computer, and what I'm going to do is just make a new folder. VirtualBox images, I'll just put it on the desktop. And what I'm going to do is unzip the archive of an image. And then I'll place the image within the folder. You can place your folder wherever you choose. I just have it on the desktop to make it easy for this tutorial. Okay, the four operating systems I downloaded as an example are now ready for VirtualBox. I'll go into VirtualBox here, and I'll start with a new virtual machine. The type is Linux, and this will be 64-bit. I'll click on Next. This requires a bit of RAM, so I'll increase it. And this all depends upon the system memory that you have installed on your computer. You don't want to use all of your RAM because you need this to run your computer also. So I'm going to allocate some for the virtual machine. You can always change this later on. Click on Next. Here, we'll use the existing virtual hard disk that we downloaded. This is the disk image. I'll go into the desktop where I put my VirtualBox images, and I'll select the correct one. I'll open that up, click on Create. Now, what I'm going to do is right mouse click, and I'll go to Settings, or you can go to Settings up there. I'll go into System, and here you can change the RAM as you choose. I'll go to Processor, and this computer has four cores, so I'll set two to work with the virtual machine. Everything else looks okay, so I'll click on OK, and let's go ahead and start. Okay, this was downloaded from OS Boxes, so I'll click on the username there. You can always change the username inside of the settings of any virtual machine. And the password is osboxes.org. I'll sign in. I'll increase the size of the window here. Right mouse click, virtual screen. Set it to this size. There we are. And here it is running. This is about as quick and painless as you can get. Okay, I'll shut this down. And let's go ahead and install OpenSolaris. I'll click on New. The type will be Solaris, version 10 and earlier. Okay, I'll select that. Since I think I downloaded version 9, click on Next. I'll allocate about 4 GB. Next, use existing virtual hard disk. I'll go ahead and choose it, open Solaris, open, create. Let's go start that. Okay, this is running pretty clean with just one processor. Username is OpenS. Okay, that's installed. Shut it down. Try another one. Let's try Android. Android is Linux. We'll have other Linux. I think this is a 64-bit. Click on Next. Install 4 GB. Next. Open. We'll have Android. And within the settings, I'll just keep it as one processor. This is under display. Processor 1. If I wanted to, I can increase it, but right now I'll just keep it as 1. We'll start. And there's Android running on the PC. Okay, let's do free DOS. I'll click on New. We want free DOS. Type other version DOS, next. Don't need to allocate too much RAM for it. Next. And open up the free DOS image. Go ahead, start. And there it is. Okay, I'll close this down and we'll just power off the machine.